we ever leave British Columbia.
We were being chased.
It's beautiful. There's Felicia.
Hello?
Hi.
How'd the trip go?
Oh, pretty good for me. I slept most of the way. What about you?
Shall we get in the car? We have a pretty long drive, don't we?
Yeah.
You're sure we're in the right city and the right country this time?
Hi.
You're back.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks.
I got it, yeah. No problem.
This place is kind of a mess. My backup never showed.
Yeah, you guys must have had a big rush this morning for breakfast.
We do every day. This place is like a landmark around here. Do you want breakfast or lunch?
Is it too late for eggs?
With pancakes, bacon, and hash browns?
I could go for that, yeah.
Okay, you got it. You must like this place. You here for hours yesterday, now again today?
I'm waiting for some folks to show up. My parents, actually. I'm supposed to be meeting them here.
How'd you ever pick a place like this?
Well, like you said, it's a landmark.
General Hospital on ABC, brought to you by new Tostitos Snack Kits, a whole new way to dig in. Kick back.
Taxi! Taxi!
59th Street Video, please.
Oh, you gotta get the episode one video. Wait till you see the pod racing scene. Young Skywalker's racing for freedom. This is where the video kicks butt. He goes into overdrive. He never stops for anything. Never stops for... Well, you gotta see it for yourselves. From the big screen to your screen, buy the Star Wars episode one video, some Pepsi, Tostitos tortilla chips, and get $3 back. Oh, joy.
It's changing time. Oh, hold on.
Love's wipes cost less. But are these wipes too thick and strong? I guess that's why Love's calls them ultra thicks.
My fellow Americans, this is the best concert ever.
Betsy Wilson reporting to you live from...
Awesome party.
Roger 842.
Houston, we've landed on Mars.
Whatever they've imagined doing for almost as long as anyone can remember.
Unbelievable! A new world record!
Girls have known there was a place to find a friend who could show them how. Don't miss the Big Barbie event all month long, only at Toys R Us. The one place that's all for them.
That's me, the one pounding the pavement, and this is my lucky suit. I have 5 job interviews this week. Here goes number 3. Yikes.
Really?
Ooh, nice. Ever hear of a napkin? Whew, lucky for me, there's new custom cleaner home dry cleaning kit. I just use this cloth to remove stains, then toss it in the bag and in the dryer. 20 minutes on low heat, and my suit is clean, fresh, and ready to face the world again. Custom Cleaner. Take your dry cleaning to your dryer.
Cold stuff kill you? Then try new Colgate Sensitive Maximum Strength. It's clinically proven to provide significantly more pain relief than Sensodyne, so you don't have to be afraid of anything. New Colgate Sensitive.
Ziploc containers. Test number 8. If you can't remember how long they've been in the fridge, just remember one is affordable enough to throw away. Ziploc, all you ever wanted in a container.
The future of hockey is here, so check it out. Sunday, it's Red Wings Avalanche, Coyote Stars, or Kings Mighty Ducks. The NHL on ABC.
Let me know if you need any ketchup or anything.
Oh, no, nothing.
Darn, this thing never closes.
Here, you gotta lift up on the key, and then shove it hard.
How'd you know that?
I used to work here.
You did? When?
When I was little. My parents owned this place.
No kidding.
My dad bought that register secondhand. I'm amazed that it still works.
It's on its last legs. No wonder you and your parents are meeting here. What's your name?
Lucky Spencer. I'm one of the triple L's.
Katie. My dad owns the boat rental place outside of town.
Really? Hmm? We used to rent from him during salmon season.
I can't believe we never met.
Well, I was only here 9 months.
Where'd you go to school?
Hudson Elementary.
I went to Providence. Guess that explains why we never ran into each other.
I had a great time here, though. Camping out, watching the elk walk through town in spring.
They still do that right down the middle of Water Street. How come you moved away?
Well, my folks are kind of like that. We were always moving. We never really settled anywhere.
I'm glad you came back to visit.
Me too. You know, it's funny how I got here. But it feels right.
Can I get you anything else?
A little more juice would be great.
You got it.
Here you go. Let me know if there's anything else you need, okay? Hi.
Hi. You seem really on edge.
Yeah, well, every time that door opens, I expect Lucky to be standing there. Not that he's just gonna show up here. I know he'll come home with Luke and Laura, or he'll call, or...
Have you gotten in touch with his parents?
I wonder if they're near him right now, when we're thinking about him.
Can you imagine the look on Lucky's face and how he's gonna feel when he sees them?
Well, how he's gonna feel about everything. I mean, he's been held prisoner for almost a year. That has to have changed him.
No. No matter what, Lucky will always be Lucky.
What is it? What if it doesn't fit anymore? You know, like the way we used to know what the other was thinking without even saying anything? What if that's not there?
Listen, Elizabeth. Lucky's gonna walk in that door. He's gonna look at you. You're gonna look at him. And you're gonna realize that he loves you just as much as you love him.
There. That's the old town we used to live in.
How long a drive is it?
It's about an hour. We'll go to the old house, see if anything's there, and if that doesn't help, then we'll go to the Triple L. How's Lulu?
She misses us. Are we good to go?
Yeah, let's hit the rental car agency.
I'm gonna warn my men you're working for the feds. Once the feds know that your cover's blown, they're gonna come looking for you. Take the money and disappear.
Whoa. Thanks. Thanks a lot, but I got other plans. And you really don't owe me anything.
You could have kept your mouth shut and busted me.
Uh-huh. And you put yourself on the line to save Bobby's life. In my book, that makes us even.
Watch your back.
You too.
Roy is obviously not worth whatever you're putting yourself through.
You don't know him.
No, I don't, but I know that he has been lying to you since he moved into this town.
Look, I love him. I always have. And he loves me. I thought you understood that.
I had to warn Sonny.
Roy was trying to turn things around. He was trying to break with the FBI so we could be together, and you just ruined any chance he had of working things out.
What is there to work out?
Doesn't matter now,
no,
does it?
What is there to work out? He told you when that he was a fed, yesterday.
The night he rescued me.
You've known for a week that he was a spy? I guess he told you that about Hannah, too, right?
What difference does that make?
I just really like to know.
I've known for quite a while that Hannah was Roy's daughter.
And you didn't say anything to Sonny?
Because Roy was trying to protect Hannah, and I promised that I would keep it a secret.
You didn't even try to warn Sonny. How could you do that?
Because Roy and I were trying to figure out a way to get him free from the FBI so he wouldn't have to go to prison.
Yeah, you know the way to do that? There's only one way to do that, Mom. That would be if Roy did turn Sonny into the feds. Then Sonny would go to prison.
Carly,
instead of
we
Roy.
We didn't want that.
Well, let me tell you something. Roy was not the only one who was there the night you were rescued. Sonny was there too. And you were still ready to nail him. He put himself on the line for you. Don't you see what Roy's doing? He's using you. This has got nothing to do with love.
Last year, billions of dollars were spent on emergency equipment. Unfortunately, some communities missed out on this money. Fill out your census. It helps determine public funding for emergency equipment. Census 2000. Mail it back today.
How different can best friends be? Take our weddings. Julia, totally traditional. Me, totally untraditional. And Holly, Las Vegas. But yesterday we discovered that we'd all made the same decision about one thing.
I'm taking the pill. Ortho-tricycline.
Me too. And you know, when you take it correctly, it's over 99% effective.
So there's no worry about getting pregnant.
Till you want to.
And just look at my skin.
Ortho-tricycline?
Mm-hmm. My doctor told me it's the only one with clinical proof that it helps clear up moderate acne.
Yeah. My skin is definitely clearer.
The pill does not protect against HIV or sexually transmitted diseases. Serious risks include blood clot, stroke, and heart attack. Cigarette smoking increases these risks, especially if you're a smoker over 35. Women who use the pill are urged not to smoke. Women who have blood clots, certain cancers, a history of heart attack or stroke, and those who could be pregnant should not use the pill. For more information, talk to your healthcare provider.
If you're going to take the pill, why not take the only one with clinical proof? It helps your skin look better. Or the tricycline.
Are we ever gonna eat?
We all do dumb things. Hmm. Paying too much for car insurance doesn't have to be one of them. Geico. A 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance. We all do dumb things. Paying too much for car insurance doesn't have to be one of them. Geico. A 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Great news for all you cats.
Chuck!
Marv, we can't buy this stuff ourselves.
I'm up.
The Whiskers you love in a can now comes in a flavor-lock pouch.
Whiskers. What cats want?
Busy morning? We've got you covered. Burger King has delicious new pancake minis. Light buttermilk silver dollar pancakes with rich syrup so you can dip them and eat them on the go. Just 99 cents for a limited time. Only at Burger King.
This little piggy went to market.
These piggies have power. With the Kickstart Gym from Play School. One kick. Starts music and silly fun, and that's a pretty big step for little piggies. The Kickstart Gym from Play School.
Boogie woogie, rumbling round. Creamy, dreamy, rumbling round. It's got yogurt blended right in. With the creamy taste of butter, you'll try it.
The goodness of yogurt, the creamy taste of butter with half the fat and calories. Must be rumbling round.
You know, I was with Sonny when he found out Sorrel was holding you, and we were on a plane back to Port Charles so fast.
I know that, Carly, and I am very grateful.
No, you don't know. You can't possibly know and have ever considered selling him out to the FBI. He risked going to prison for you, Mother. He risked being shot at by Sorrel. That's how you pay him back.
Sonny was never in any danger. Roy never gave the FBI anything they could use against
him. You believe this from a man who has done nothing but lie to you.
Stop it.
I feel sorry for you. You know what I do? I know what it's like to love the wrong man. But I am not going to sell Sonny out so that you and Roy can ride off into the sunset and live happily ever after.
I never wanted to hurt Sonny.
You did, so why didn't you warn him a week ago? You're not the only one who owes Sonny. He got Michael and I away from the Quartermaines. He gave us a place to live, and he is taking care of me and my baby.
What is this? I thought you couldn't stand Sonny.
Well, I don't have to like him to do right by him.
Look, Roy and Sonny are not necessarily on opposite sides.
Since when?
All Sonny has to do is feed Roy some false information that he can take back to the FBI. That will give Roy some time.
To do what?
To figure out how he's going to stay out of jail.
What's in it for Sonny?
As long as the FBI thinks that Roy is still on the case, they're not going to assign another agent to Sonny. This could work for both of them, so please, will you do me a favor? Just please go to Sonny and try to make him understand that.
Oh, sure, Mom, yeah. Do it in a heartbeat for you. You know what happened the last time I tried to interfere in Sonny's business. You remember? He froze me out for a week straight.
This is to save Roy's life.
Well, so was last time when I let you into Sonny's desk. I didn't think he was gonna forgive me, Mother, but he did, and I am not gonna rock the boat.
You owe me for helping Jason.
That is completely different.
No, no, it was not different. Jason got shot. I treated the wound. I didn't report it to the police. I risked my nursing license and my job because he was the man you love. Now I'm asking you to help me save the man I love.
Roy is not Jason. He's not even close.
I can't do it. You mean you won't?
Whatever.
Then leave. Leave.
Fine, fine.
Oh, excuse me. Maybe you could help me. I seem to be a little lost.
What are you looking for?
The Corinthos Morgan warehouse.
You in a business to buy some coffee?
Coffee? No, really.
Well, that's
no.
What they do.
No, no, I know that. Oh, okay. I just need to meet one of the owners, a Sonny Corinthos. And please, don't warn me about him. I already know he's a hoodlum and a blackmailer and a plague on Port Charles. I really don't care about his little life of crime. I just want to talk to him, just for a minute, and then I will be out of his life forever, I promise you.
What do you want to talk to him about?
No, I think that's between him and me, don't you?
Okay.
Okay, you're... Oh, you're not.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no, you're not.
Sonny Corinthos?
Oh, no.
How can I help you?
Oh, Lord, I am sorry.
No.
I'm Ray Cummings. Hello.
Hi.
I'm a little embarrassed, to say the least.
Oh, sorry.
No.
People do it all the time.
Do they? I bet they do with you.
If you're looking for your girlfriend, she's not there.
I should have figured you'd show up at some point.
I hear you got fired from the warehouse. Corinthos must have found out you were working for the FBI.
Well, it could be he just doesn't like the way I load coffee. You think that's it?
Doesn't matter. Your cover's blown. You're no longer any good to the Bureau.
And is this your opinion, or are you here as a messenger for Ford?
Just trying to give you a little advance warning, that's all.
Uh-huh.
Agent Ford will be calling you in tomorrow.
And you're telling me this, why? Out of the goodness of your heart?
That's right.
Well, thanks for the heads up.
Better kiss the redhead goodbye. After tomorrow, you'll only be seeing her on visiting day.
Dude, you're in a big hurry, aren't you, to lock me up and throw away the key?
And wait till Hannah gets wind of the fact that her daddy's not an FBI super agent, that he's a convicted felon, a snitch.
You mess with my daughter, you will answer to me.
Get your hands off of me.
Or what? I'm a convicted felon. Remember, I got nothing to lose. But then again, you're not worth it.
Your history, DeLuca. Tomorrow, you go back to prison, where you belong.
So, have you started planning what you and Lucky are gonna do together when he comes home?
I have trouble imagining our first meeting.
Well, you don't have to go back to the Art Academy. I mean, you can stay in Port Charles. And Lucky will write songs about you and for you. Hey, can you imagine how much fun it's gonna be, the four of us hanging out together?
Juan and Lucky have to get to know each other first.
Well, they'll get to know each other. I mean, they'll be friends, right? It'd be terrible if they didn't like each other.
Of course they're gonna like each other. They have a lot in common.
Yeah, that is true. I mean, they have their music. Hey, what if Lucky works at L&B Records? I mean, you know, that way that they could kind of team up, Lucky and Juan. Lucky could write music and Juan could sing. Or maybe they could do it together. They could sing together, you know, Lucky and Juan.
Don't count on it.
Why?
Any plans you have for me to be a singer? At the rate I'm going, I won't have enough money to cut a demo until I'm 50.
Has the town changed much since you lived here?
It's about the same, except for the
New mall?
It has a 7-theater complex, all first-run films.
Wow. Well, that sure beats driving all the way to Vancouver to see a movie, huh?
Yeah. I saw snow falling on cedars there. Oh, some of it was filmed nearby. It was so beautiful. It's about a boy and a girl who grew up in this area, and they... maybe you've seen it.
No. Actually, I haven't seen a movie in a long time.
If you want to go... What's wrong?
There's someone out there, a man.
So?
He's gonna come in here looking for me. I needed some place to hide. Is there anywhere I can hide?
Okay, under the counter. Does he have a tight beard and glasses?
Yes.
He's here. Sorry, mister, we're not serving lunch yet.
I just need some information. I'm looking for someone. A young man, about your age.
This Easter, find fun somewhere new.
Over here?
Over here!
Pillsbury Easter cookies, with bunnies and tulips in the middle. Just slice, bake, and eat. Make their holiday the Doughboy way.
Found something.
Before Easter hops away.
It loves to move. It has a heart-shaped birthmark.
Dove knows your skin is important, even the skin under your arms.
They started salsa dancing. They lift up your arm, and their face goes right in your armpit. You're worried about your deodorant not working, and it freaks you out. So I tried Dove deodorant.
New maximum strength Dove antiperspirant, made with 1/4 moisturizer. It cares for your skin.
It has moisturizer, so your skin's soft and smooth.
It's strong protection with a touch of Dove.
I don't have to be paranoid. I use Dove.
I wasted way too much time being fat. I would go up and down and up and down. Look at me. I lost over 50 pounds on this Slim Fast plan, and I kept it off for over 3 years. I didn't know I looked like this underneath. It's not only about being thin. It's about feeling good and having energy. I exercise. I eat right. I have a shake for lunch every day. It helps me stay this way.
If you know your ABCs, you know the vitamins in Slim Fast. It's a fun way of rejuvenating your body.
Slim Fast. Every day. Get healthy.
It can happen to you.
To grow big and strong, kids need all the calcium they can get. And Kix has the most calcium of any leading kid cereal. As much as the milk you pour on it.
How did you get so big?
It's the Kix.
Kix. Kid tested. Mother approved.
Our eyes have natural moisturizers, tears, so we took ingredients found in natural tears, added more moisturizers than any leading drop, and put them in Visine Tears. For soothing relief, Visine Tears, it gets the dry out.
General Hospital will continue in a moment, here on ABC.
25 years ago, John had a brief affair, uncovering intimate secrets on the next Montel.
Montel, today at 3 on San Diego's 10.
You hear about it, but you never expect it to hit so close to home. I'm talking about rape. We went to a friend's house to party and drink, and my friend met this incredibly sweet guy. But she got so drunk. He helped her to one of the rooms. I never expected something like that from him. She was so drunk, she didn't know what was happening to her until it was too late. I should have been the one to help her, not him.
Hi, I'm Evan. Try some fruschetta? It's great.
No, thanks. When I want good pizza, I go out.
I'll take you out.
Be gentle. Be gentle.
Hush up. You're making my ankle swell.
Have a nice day.
If you think you gotta go out for great pizza, you'd never try fruschetta.
There, you're out. Fruschetta?
It's got a self-rising crust and fresh out of the pizza oven taste.
This is great.
Try fruschetta. It's better.
Fruschetta?
No, I go out for pizza.
I'm getting too old for this.
At some drugstores, they seem to think people only get sick between 9 and 5. At Save-On, we know better. When most everybody else is closed, there's a Save-On pharmacy near you that's open all day, all night, all year. At Save-On, you can count on people who care.
It never gets tired or sick, and it's delivering better health care to you here in San Diego. Meet a hospital super worker tonight on 10 News Live at 5.
Have you seen him?
Sure. He was in here yesterday with an older woman.
Elegant looking? And you haven't seen him since?
Sorry.
Thank you.
Stay put, he's still outside. Okay, he's gone.
Are you sure?
He's getting in his car.
You handled that like a pro.
Why is he looking for you? Are you in some kind of trouble?
Trouble is what I'm trying to avoid.
Well, the Quartermains didn't hold back when it came to you. Lila was the only one that didn't say anything bad about you.
Well, I guess I can't be all that bad.
Guess not. Yeah. I really am sorry I called you a hoodlum and all that other stuff. You are not at all what I expected.
Well, see, the Quartermains have a tendency to exaggerate. So what do you need to talk to me about?
I'm looking for some important documents. Mm-hmm. They're family records. They're in a Bible that's in a desk, an antique desk, a roll top. I was told that it was delivered to you.
Yeah, it was last week, a gift from a friend.
Did you look inside? Is there a Bible?
Well, I didn't look in the desk because it didn't fit in my place, so I gave it to charity.
Oh, God. I have to find this Bible.
I donated to the Richmond Avenue thrift shop. The money goes to the clinic. They only picked it up yesterday,
okay,
so it must...
Then maybe they still have it. I'll go look.
Yeah.
Listen, thank you.
Hey, it's my pleasure.
And again, I'm sorry.
Things happen, you
know. Yeah, I guess so. Anyway, thanks.
All right.
The thought of this is what's kept me going all day.
I'm so worried.
Don't worry. It's gonna be a good night. Nothing's gonna spoil it.
I wanted tonight to be special.
It is. It already is. We're gonna go out. Gonna paint the town. Gonna treat you to lobster and champagne at the fanciest place we can find.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
What are we celebrating?
My severance pay.
You saw Sonny?
I did. And just like you've been telling me, he's actually an okay guy once you get to know him. You know, he's all right. I'm sure the lobster's one night if we, first stop is gonna be that jewelry store on the mall. I want you to pick out something elegant to set off that beautiful outfit. Maybe, earrings.
You're gonna blow your severance pay all in one evening.
And that is the idea. To us, Bobby.
To us. What are you not saying?
It doesn't need to be said. It's just important that we make this a memorable night because it's probably going to be the last one we have for a while.
No, you are not going away. Not again.
Bobby, I've turned it over.
Look, you just told me that Sonny was okay with you. So maybe the two of you can find a way to work together.
Sonny's gonna tell his men tomorrow that I have been working for the FBI. Larkin already knows my cover is blown. I'm scheduled to meet with Ford in the morning.
What will he do?
He'll ask me if I've turned up any new information on Corinthos. I'll say no, and he'll set the machinery in motion that's gonna send me back to prison.
Then you have to stall him till we can figure something out.
That's not gonna happen.
Roy, you are not going back to prison.
I don't have a choice, and I don't want to get lost in that tonight.
We need to be here. What I need more than anything, Bobby, is tonight alone with you.
I won't let you go back. I won't.
Can I get you anything else?
No, no, fine. I'm fine. I'm just waiting for somebody, all right?
Okay, I'll be back to check on you. Look, Juan, you have a real natural talent. Ned told you that. How can you let something like money get in your way? Why can't Ned back you?
LMB isn't on its feet yet. They don't have the money to back an unknown.
Yeah, but Ned said that you can use LMB equipment.
Which is great, but I still have to come up with the money to cover musicians. I mean, someone to lay down the tracks. It's a fortune.
Okay, well, what about asking your father in Puerto Rico? Won't he back you?
He's got me on the university business school track. And taking over the family department stores is his dream for me.
Yeah, I understand.
I was hoping to have a CD made before he ever found out.
Hey, what about Nicholas? I mean, he can get his hands on money, no problem.
There's no way I'm letting Nicholas back my music career.
Well, if you stay that stubborn, you're not gonna have a singing career.
You're gonna need to win the lottery or a singing contest.
Yeah, or... Well, you know what? You could give your business idea to grandfather.
Your grandfather thinks I'm a bad influence.
No, he's way over that. Well, almost. But listen, grandfather is always looking for new business ventures to invest in.
An unknown singer?
Yeah, we could go to grandmother first. That's what we could do. We'll go to grandmother first, we'll tell her about it, she'll convince grandfather, and there's no way that he's gonna say no to her.
Yeah, and hey, you've already got yourself a promoter.
How did I get so lucky?
It's not my fault I think you're gonna be a natural star.
Well, right now the star has to go sweep up at LMB.
Need a hand?
You can come keep me company.
Call me if you hear anything, okay?
You'll be the first to know.
Bye.
Bye.
Sorry I'm late.
Oh,
I got held up at the hospital.
Don't apologize. I really appreciate all the help you're giving me.
So, did the desk have a Bible?
I had a complete dead end.
She called Bobby, my ex-wife, because she knows Sonny.
Oh, no, I've already met him.
Not too unpleasant, I hope.
Actually, I found him charming and gracious and even humorous, contrary to what everybody's telling me.
No comment.
But he doesn't have my desk. He gave it away to charity. So he donated it to a thrift shop. I called them just now, but nobody's there. They're closed, I guess.
Tell me the name of the thrift shop. I'll look it up. I'll give you directions. You go tomorrow.
I just hope they haven't sold the desk. It's the Richmond Avenue thrift shop.
You're in luck.
I've got a lead on Lucky.
Oh, my God. Where is he? Is he okay?
I don't know for sure, but I think he's in British Columbia. Well, Miss Lansbury told me that's where Stefan went today.
Lucky used to live there. I mean, his family owned a diner.
I've got the name of the town it's in. If we leave now, we can be in British Columbia by tonight. What do you say?
I'm serious when it comes to wrinkles. So I use New Line Eraser from L'Oreal Paris with retinol.
The most serious anti-wrinkle action you may ever take.
To help erase first lines, fine lines, even those lines we've learned to live with.
Line Eraser with pure retinol.
With buttery, flaky Ritz.
Oh, yeah.
Soup becomes irresistible. Nothing fits like a Ritz.
One of these women uses Suave Herbal Care Mousse. The other spends a lot more for Clairol Herbal Essences. Both have hair that looks beautifully full. So who uses Suave and who spends more? If you can't tell, why should we? Suave. Don't you look smart?
3 days guaranteed one of a kind. The first 3 days of Sears Days. The only days when practically anything for your home, your yard, and yourself come at some of our best prices of the season. 3 days of all appliances and electronics, all tractors and mowers, all sorts of tools and tool storage, all on sale. The first part of Sears Days is big, and it's the part that's over. Saturday, Sears Days. The good life at a great price. guaranteed.
You were born with naturally beautiful skin. Keep it that way with Huggies Natural Care Baby Wipes. The only wipes with a mild formula containing vitamin E, aloe, and purified water. They maintain your baby's naturally healthy skin as they thoroughly clean, wipe after gentle wipe. Keep skin petal soft. For natural care, there's nothing like Huggies.
One, two, unbuckle my shoe. Three, four, add two more. Five, six, start to mix. Seven, eight, collaborate. Nine, ten, start again.
Help your skin look young again with St. Ives Lotion. Only St. Ives contains collagen and elastin, the proteins in young-looking skin, leaving you with hands that look as young as you feel. St. Ives Lotion. Advanced botanicals for better skin.
Tonight, talk about outrageous body shops, smashing your car, gouging you for money, using old, damaged parts, putting you at risk. Afraid of getting ripped off? You won't believe this. 2020 investigates tonight.
He's done some incredible duets, though.
I mean, absolutely amazing.
Simply incredible. And they're even more incredible, considering that he's harmonizing with a duck. Huh? He's been a, he's like
he's
a crooner.
That old school high falsetto thing. Yeah.
That ball is out of here.
Eddie's career was over.
Whoops.
Until his daughter's prayer was answered.
I'm an angel, Lord.
I am here to help Eddie win the pennant.
No! You gotta be kidding.
Well, we're kind of rusty.
Now.
Let's do it!
She's taking the Angels under her wing.
Believe, Dad!
And giving them a chance at the championship.
Wow. Have you done this before?
Patrick Warburton, David Alan Grier, Angels in the Infield. Sunday at 7, 6 Central on the wonderful World of Disney.
Why is that guy after you?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you. I didn't steal from him or anything. I wouldn't get you mixed up in anything illegal.
Well, whatever it is, this has not been a dull day.
I just wish there was some way I could thank you.
You could take me to the movies.
I'd like that, but unfortunately, I'm not going to be here that long.
I'll take a rain check then, if you're ever in town again.
You're on.
You know, if you were in trouble, you could tell me. I'd help you, no questions asked.
You don't even know me.
Feels like I do. And I bet you'd help me if I needed it.
Yes, I would.
I hope you're gonna be okay.
Better than that. I'm done living in the past. The future is what it's about now. Are you okay?
Yeah, it's just so fast. I mean, after all these months, are you sure Lucky's in British Columbia?
If Stefan is there, I'm willing to bet on it.
Oh, God, I wonder if Luke and Laura know.
I've left messages for them everywhere.
I can't believe this.
And we can be on a plane in a couple of hours.
Wait. Let's just not get up and go. I mean, you're not even sure Lucky's really there, so.
Yeah, you're right. Maybe it would be better if we thought it through first, especially if my grandmother's still holding Lucky when Stefan gets there.
There could be trouble. That's what you were gonna say, wasn't it?
No, not for Lucky. Elena's protected him.
Yeah, until she knew that Luke was after them. I mean, what if all this time Lucky's been alive, and now that everybody's closing
hey,
in...
Hey, no, Lucky's alive. And one way or the other, we are going to see him. Soon.
Okay, if we don't hear anything by tomorrow, let's just go, because I can't take another day not knowing something.
All right, it's a deal.
Okay, Val. All right, we're on our way. Bye. Oh, we can go to the thrift shop tonight.
How did you manage that?
Because I volunteer at the clinic. Val is the director of the clinic, and so she'll call someone and have them open the place up for us.
I don't know what to say. I can't thank you enough.
Well, I actually kind of know what you're going through. Bobby and I had a child that died.
I'm sorry, I didn't know that.
Yeah, and after that, you know, Lucas, my son, became the whole focus of my life, and I had a couple of bad years and I couldn't see him, so I know the hell that you go through when you know that your child's out there somewhere, but you can't find him.
But you see him now?
Oh, yeah, all the time. And maybe while you're in town, you could meet him.
Oh, I'd love that.
I hope that if you get to meet your daughter, she's one half the person that you are.
How could she not, huh? She's got my blood running through her. Mm.
Well, on the way over to the thrift shop, I'll tell you a cautionary tale about a mother and a long-lost daughter.
Boy, it sounds like a story not with a happy ending. I'm right, aren't I? Yeah.
What are those bugs doing? Are they, they're so upset. They're very, very mad. Very, very upset.
Another bug.
Hi, I know that's another bug. And what is he doing?
Don't let me stop you.
We're just finishing up a book. Michael, do you want to show Uncle Sonny the pictures? Look at this.
You read him that stuff with all those, like, weird creatures or what?
Oh, it's his favorite.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You don't think it makes him a little S-C-A-R-Y? How you doing, buddy?
He loves it.
Because you're a tough kid. You're a tough kid. Come here. I'm going to show you something. No, this way. Come here. Look at this. Watch this. Bring your little truck. Look out this window. You probably don't remember this, but when you were a little baby, he used to look out this window every night. You see that big building over there? You own half of it. Same with the pier.
That ain't going in now.
Yeah, well, that too. You own everything, you know what I mean? Huh? Maybe one day I'll take you to see the whole place. What do you think?
I don't know, maybe one day the three of us, we could go.
Yeah?
Yeah, I mean, it's big and everything you say echoes. I think he'd love that.
You ready to go to sleep, Michael?
Yeah, it's time.
Let's go. Oh, no, I got him. We're gonna go upstairs, we're gonna play. You're gonna run that truck. You're getting heavy. This boy's getting heavy, I'm telling you that.
Tell me about it.
If you're sure that the Bureau is sending you back to prison, then you've got to run. You know how the FBI works. You could change your identity. They would never find you.
That might work for a while, but, I'd always be looking over my shoulder, waiting for the day when they finally kick the door in.
But that day might never come.
No, it always comes. That's how I've been living. I can't live like that anymore.
At least you'd be free.
No, it's not really freedom. It's just another kind of prison. And there's no peace in it, believe me. Taking orders from people you don't respect, lying to people who trust you, turning them in and blowing up their lives. I've been doing that for 20 years. I can't do it anymore. If I do, I'm gonna be gone. It feels so good to be able to tell Sonny the truth. It feels so good to know that I'm not gonna cut any more deals with those guys. I'm not gonna run. If I have to do more time, whatever. I'll be able to hold my head up. I have to do it, you understand?
I do understand. I understand, but it's so wrong.
I know. And I'm sorry that I came back here to you before I turned that page. I just couldn't help it.
Don't be sorry. Don't ever think that. We lost 20 years. But we're together now. And I love you. And whatever happens, I'm going to go on loving you.
Telephones can go unanswered, and it's perfectly acceptable to have tea with your high school sweetheart and Cornelius from Planet of the Apes. And you're cordially invited to visit each and every night by Serta. We make the world's best mattress. Presenting modern rock, 24 new wave dance hits. All your favorite 80s dance hits.
modern rock on two CDs or two cassettes for just $12.99.
I'll stop the world and melt with you. You see the difference and it's getting better.
Wake me up before you go, go. Don't leave me hanging on like a yo-yo. Wake me up before you go, go.
We can dance if we want to. We can leave your friends behind. Cause your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, that are no friends of mine.
You are an obsession, you're my obsession. Who do you want me to do?
Then audition other modern rock albums. There's no minimum to buy. Satisfaction guaranteed.
If you leave, I won't cry. I'll always.
Modern rock is not in stores. So call now for Modern Rock.
To order Modern Rock, call 1-800-517-3399. That's 1-800-517-3399. Or send $12.99 plus $3.99 shipping and handling to Modern Rock, Department 4, Richmond, Virginia, 23280.
Lobster Fest. That's right. Red Lobster's annual celebration of lobster all the ways you love it. Dipped, steamed, broiled, and baked. Hey, with prices this low, timing is everything. So escape to Red Lobster for Lobster Fest.
These musicians share one dream, to become the next music sensation.
This is more important to me than anything else in the whole world.
For three of them, life is about to get ugly.
If I put the work in, I'm gonna get better.
Because they're about to get the axe.
You're not nailing down your parts that well.
An all-new Making the Band tonight after Sabrina on ABC.
I want you to do me a favor.
If it's what I think it is, the answer is no.
Bobby, come on. When I go back, I don't want you sitting around here twiddling your thumbs, waiting on some parole date that might not come.
If you go back, that will be my life. And it's not what I want. But I'll take you any way you come.
Just spinning my wheels arguing with you, aren't I, Red?
Maybe you're wising up.
You changed my life, you know. That day on the docks. When you called my name and I turned and it was you. That kiss. I knew I was home. I've never stopped loving you, Bobby. I never will.
I can't believe he went right to sleep for you.
You know, it's a guy thing, you know? They know who's boss.
Oh, right? Yeah? Yeah?
Yeah.
I don't think so. You know what the truth is, though?
Huh?
This place, it's a home for Michael. Yeah. Since we came here, he doesn't wake up in the middle of the night and cry for Jason anymore. So I gotta thank you for that.
You're welcome. Hey, you know what? Let me get this. You know what I mean.
You know, I have my appointment with Dr. Meadows next week for my ultrasound.
Yeah?
Yeah, you can come if you want to.
Okay, if you, let me know when it is so I can, plan around it, you know?
Plan what?
our wedding. I talked to Father Coates and, he's gonna marry us next week.
Oh.
Andreas. Tell the pilots I'm ready to leave and bring the champagne. Today definitely calls for a celebration.
What are you celebrating, Mother? It wouldn't have anything to do with Lucky Spencer, would it?
What's different?
The name's the same. Luke. He's gotta be here. He's just gotta be here.
I'll wait out here and watch for Helena.
Boy.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next General Hospital.
What if you could share every moment? What if you could experience all the wonder? What if you could see it all? Again. Now you can share it all with your family on video. Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace.
We haven't much time.
The one to own on video.
I expect a lot of my family. I expect Joe to get heartburn, Tony to get nausea, and Sarah indigestion at the mere sight of food. Instead, Joe would get indigestion, Tony diarrhea, and I'd end up with heartburn. I just keep first aid handy at all times.
Pepto-Bismol relieves more stomach problems than any of these other leading medicines.
I expect the unexpected.
Pepto-Bismol, first aid for heartburn, diarrhea, nausea, indigestion, and upset stomachs.
Gerber has a surprising way to calm your baby down at bedtime. Introducing Gerber Baby Wash. The first with natural soothing lavender. It's Gerber safe and gentle. With warm water, here's a natural way to calm and relax him. Just in time for bedtime.
Yes, your baby has you, and you have Gerber.
Shouldn't your baby be a Gerber baby? Look for all the new products in the Gerber aisle to help keep your baby healthy and happy.
Go away.
Come on, we're gonna be late.
Saturday.
Dum, dum, da dum.
Tom's wedding.
Here, John. Have some breakfast.
Kellogg's Nutri-Grain Bars.
Low fat? No preservatives? We're not that late, are we?
Great soft baked crust and real fruit filling.
I'd eat this even if I wasn't late.
And when would that be?
Kellogg's Nutri-Grain Bars. Good food to go.
Okay, so you're not a brain surgeon. You're not married to one. Man, you haven't even paid off your car loan. Hey, why don't you hang out with someone who doesn't care about any of that stuff? A kid. Become a mentor. Put children first.
On the next General Hospital.
You're looking for a desk.
We are getting married. No joke.
Luke and Laura will soon discover the depths of my revenge.
What's the matter? Talk to me, please.
Cast your vote in the General Hospital weekly poll, only at abc.com, part of the Go Network.
The whole institution of marriage is crumbling.
I'm not married.
And, but you
in
really
case
want
you
to
don't know.
That's what I like about the view.
Monday, Malcolm
Beckham himself, Frankie Muniz. Plus, Joy's Comedy Corner, nominated for 12 Emmys. It's an all-new View on ABC Daytime. Hey!
I'll see you.
On ABC.com.
He's a man who I have adored since I was a little girl. For 50 years, he's personified grace, one of the finest actors ever. A rare television interview.
I talked to Father Coates, and we're going to marry us next week.
I've never stopped loving you, Bobby. I never will.
What are you celebrating, Mother?
Cowboy?
Married, right? You and me? Can't you just see us walking down the aisle?
More or less.
You with the top hat and tails, me with the veil and matching tent. June would be good, don't you think? The flowers will be blooming and so will I.
How about next week?
April's iffy. The weather could go either way. Wouldn't want my mile-long train getting caught in a blizzard now, would we?
Yeah, you got a strange sense of humor.
You have an even stranger sense of humor.
Well, how about we throw out dinner or something?
What, no matron of honor? Monica would be crushed. And all my friends, you know, my girlfriends would be lining up around the block to be my bridesmaids. Emily, Elizabeth, that lady that sells hot dogs down by the docks. Where would we put the crowds of adoring friends that gathered to throw rose petals at our feet?
Benny throw rose petals. I'm sure Johnny would, too, if I asked him.
I wish Edward were here. You know, he's so completely off about you.
How about Edward as the ring bearer?
People assume that you're humorless because your fun side doesn't exactly pop out. But, you know, when you get going, you're a riot.
Edward thinks I'm humorless? Well, you know, he's partially right, because when it comes to the basics, I don't kid around. We are getting married, Carly. No joke.
Mr. Ruskin, I cannot thank you enough for letting us come in.
Anything for the Richmond Avenue Clinic.
Actually, the clinic's not involved in this.
Well, the doctor who's so committed to it is, and that's good enough for me.
Thank you. I want you to meet my friend, Ray Cummings. This is Paul Ruskin.
Pleased to meet you.
You too, Mr. Ruskin, and thanks again.
Dr. Jones tells me you're looking for a desk.
Yes, a Victorian roll-top desk. I was told that it would have been brought in the past couple of days.
It was brought in by Sonny Corinthos.
Oh, I know the piece. It opens with an old-fashioned key.
Please tell me that you haven't sold it yet.
Nope. It's definitely still here.
Yes. Thank you. Andreas!
Andreas isn't here. None of your minions are available, Mother.
How very inconvenient.
And potentially fatal for you.
More idle threats.
You give me Lucky Spencer, or you will see just how serious I am.
He isn't mine to give.
You're taxing my patience.
Lucky isn't here.
What have you done with him?
I released him, of course.
You're
expect me to believe that?
I delivered Lucky to the haven of his choice, a grim little diner outside of Vancouver.
Delivered him in what condition?
Healthy and vigorous at the peak of his youthful appeal. If you don't believe me, ask his mother. They're probably reuniting as we speak.
Well, that's a dream come true for Luke and Laura, but not very satisfying for you.
Luke and Laura will soon discover the depths of my revenge. Years.